I await. Almost, Ciri. Almost. Scathiad!
Ciri.
Ciri!
Come on, you bastards! The more, the merrier!
Something to tell you, but I'll do so afterwards.
As you expire.
Come on. you said you had something to tell me.
Alvalar has tricked us both. He set us against each other, and he's made off with Cirilla.
I don't believe you.
Thank you.
dismantle it?
Dismantle? No, I can make a tear at best. But only for a moment, because there's no...
specifics yet. Will we both get through?
No! You must go alone!
I'll come back. With Ciri.
I know!
Agarin! Ciri!
Thank you.
The gentleman will follow.
They let him... And now decent folk are afraid to leave their homes.
Captain!
Report! Fort Kite Squad. The Fundsberg division as a whole. Deserters.
Does General Voorhis know?
He's at the briefing. They're not letting anyone in.
Nonsense. Get in there and report to him at once.
The Redanians will be here shortly.
This Imperial Majesty awaits.
If the Emperor...
Speak. Ciri is dead.
How did it happen?
The White Cold. You're familiar with the prophecy? Ciri tried to stop it. She did, but paid the ultimate price.
Where is the body?
I doubt it'll ever be found.
Who else knows?
Avalach, Elven Sage. But I doubt you'll find him either.
And Yennefer?
She's decided to stay in the north. Provided you don't object.
I don't. And you?
Plenty of work for witchers after a war. I'll travel east, maybe north.
Did Cirilla say... Did she ask you to convey anything?
You weren't a good father. Ciri saw you as a threat. Even if she'd asked me to tell you something, I doubt you'd have liked to hear those words.
Understood.
If there's nothing else...
There is, but you may go. Witcher! I do not wish to see you ever again.
Need a hand with your wagon?
No. It's not exactly ours. More a captured vehicle. Booty, you might say.
Folk must have abandoned it in their rush. To where, I don't know. Be a shame for the Reds to claim it, loot it.
Change is coming.
Grown accustomed, we have.
With the Black Ones gone, witch hunters will move in. Yet life will roll on. We've to seize the day.
True that. So, let's get to work before night creeps up on us.
Sure you'd...
I believe...
Where you...
Yeah. Take it easy.
Thank you.
Master Ort.
Probably got held back. You're late.
Soldiers.
Blocking the roads, I know. No matter. You have it?
As agreed. 38.5-inch blade. Weight, just under 40 ounces. Silver-plated siderite steel core. Glyphs and runes both the length of the blade and on the hilt.
Beautiful.
Been in this trade for 3 decades. Only the best swordsman of the coin for my... When I say no witcher has, or ever had, a better weapon...
Reputation precedes you, Master Ort.
The inscription.
Dubin Hearn.
The flash that cuts through darkness.
Exactly.
Classic Elder Speech runes, no styling, simple and precise.
May I?
It is yours. If you'd like to test it, have my lackeys put out a training dummy.
Mm-hmm. Your payment. Gems only, as requested.
If you've an eye out for work, heard of Striggers prowling the Maribor Forest.
Thanks. Need to visit the tavern.
Good luck on the path.
Is it done?
Yes.
Did he believe you?
I have no idea.
For the cockatrice. And we've a new contract. It won't pay much, but I think it worth the toil.
You've been busy. It's yours.
A witch's silver sword.
Like it?
It's beautiful. May I?
Not here. You'll have ample opportunity soon enough, Witcher.
What's this inscription?
An old Witcher's motto. Had a sword like this once myself, but this one's better. Much better.
Let's try it out then.
Radovid had many faults. He was cruel, impetuous, and pathologically ambitious. But he was a tactical genius. That's undeniable. Commanding forces far outnumbered by his foes, he handily defeated the invader from the south. The Redanian eagle spread its wings, taking all the north, including Novigrad. With victory in the war against Nilfgaard secure, Radovid proceeded to complete his witchery. As they had in Novigrad, pyres burned in Temeria and Edirne, lands now liberated by the Redanian monarch. In the drive for moral renewal, Simple herbalists, pellers, healers, and non-humans, all supposed heretics, were murdered in droves. For many, freedom beneath Radovid's scepter proved more tragic than servitude to another. As long as his armies went from one victory to the next, Emir's subjects remained boundlessly obedient. When a string of humiliating defeats proved Varembri's fallible, the opposition, thus far secret, attacked. The subjects of the Emperor who had danced on the graves of his foes laid him to rest in a tomb of his own. Many islanders believed Svanriga would be no more than his ambitious mother's puppet. The young king proved them wrong, ignoring her whims and ruling with an iron hand all his own. Tired of the Jarls and their endless feuds, he resolved to turn the Isles into an absolute monarchy, modeled after those of the continent. What he resolved, he achieved, but only by shedding his countrymen's blood. Cirilla, Fiona, Ellen, Rhiannon, heir to Nilfgaard's throne, chose the life of a witcher on the path. Geralt taught her all he knew, every skill he possessed, then each set off on their own. Soon, word of the ashen-haired witcheress had spread throughout the north, from the Yoruga to the mountains of Kovir. While monarchs moved borders and populations, Geralt and Yennefer lived a calm, quiet life, far from all things political. They breakfasted well afternoon, more often than not in bed, and passed the days on lazy strolls and long conversations. Boring, you say? Perhaps. But both had sought this more than anything else.